Okay, so basically you will never see me here, you will never see my face, and this video will be in pure English, one video, and another video in pure Tagalog, pure Filipino. So for those Filipinos out there or listening in, want to listen in Filipino Tagalog version, there's another video coming up, okay? So this is first a pure English video, okay? So the title here is, we say El Nino. We think of the topic El Nino. And El Nino is associated with dryness in everything. Drought, dryness, drought, dryness. Why is it here in the Philippines, there's a terrible downpour of rain? It has been raining for 2 days straight now. Why is that? I thought we were in the state of El Nino. El Nino. E-L-N-I-N-N-O. E-L-N-I-N-O. Okay? So here's the answer. First, let's point to, firstly, in El Nino, there will be a heating of this part of the Pacific Ocean. Okay? Oh, by the way, if you will add other topics here other than my topic, specific topic, you will be confused and you will think that my explanation is terribly wrong. Okay? Please, please, do not add other topics in your mind. Once you add other topics, it will all go wrong. Okay? So this is only a single focused, F-O-C-U-S-E-D, focused topic. For that single topic only. I will not explain other means, other areas, okay? And I will do no correlations, okay? No intercorrelations, okay? Here is the basic answer to the question. Why is there terribly long rains and terribly long downpour for the Philippines? It has been raining for 2 long days now, constantly, incessant rain, and it has a large downpour, okay? So, firstly, characterize El Nino. El Nino is a heating in this part of the ocean, okay? Okay? A heating in this part of the ocean, okay? Now, please imagine you are making coffee. Oh, by the way, please let us not be, we call that in Tagalog, pilosopo. Walang pilosopo dito, okay? Please let us not be thinking of the making fun of the video and just think of what I'm saying. It is just like a comparison, okay? Comparison only. It is not true that there will be boiling here, okay? Obviously, there is no boiling here, okay? Please do not think of the boiling word and use it to make fun of my video, okay? Now, think of making coffee, okay? If you make coffee, obviously, you will boil the water, okay? Boil the water and notice that the boiling water produces more heat and more evaporation, okay? More heat, more boiling, more evaporation, okay? Now, that evaporation, obviously there is no boiling here, okay? That evaporation here from the ocean is water, and so more water evaporates, okay? More water evaporates. Now, since more water evaporates, there will be more water to collect, C-O-L-L-E-C-T, to collect. More water that will be collected up in the clouds here, up in the clouds. So, imagine, if you have more water waiting to be collected up in the clouds, okay? More water waiting to be collected up in the clouds in this part of the ocean, logic dictates that Since there is more water collected than the non-El Nino times, okay, non-El Nino times compared with the non-El Nino times, and therefore, more water, more rain will be sent down from the clouds, okay? So that's the reason why in El Nino, when it rains, note the topic, when it rains, that's the key word, when it rains, sometimes there is super excessive downpour and super excessive increased amount of downpour of water, of rainfall. Okay, so that's the reason. Compared with non-El Nino times. Okay, so that's the answer. So subscribe and follow and subscribe. So the rain forms here and it goes to the Philippines. Okay, there, that's the Philippines. So that's why the rain is forming here, more in quantity because of the El Nino heating up more of the ocean and therefore evaporating more water. That's the reason, more water. More water gets up into the clouds and more water pours down into the Philippines. Okay? So that's the reason why in El Nino, when it rains, there is a terribly large downpour, terribly large, excessive rains when it rains. Okay? So subscribe and follow and subscribe.